It's another edition of Time About the Movies, and today we're taking a look at the films of December 8th, 1995. And, last time we did this, there was not a whole lot of good movies around, but we have two movies this time around. One I have seen, the other I have not. So, I will say we'll probably have a much better show this time around, because this first movie I know enough of, and I do remember it being pretty good. So let's just talk about that one first, and that is, of course, the sequel to Father of the Bride, Father of the Bride Part 2.
Grab your coat and get your hat.
For George Banks, life was good. It was wonderfully, uneventfully predictable.
Hey! Hey, Dad, did you hear the news?
What news?
But not for long.
Hi, Dad.
I know what it is. You bought a house, right?
I thought you guys were going to have a baby.
Get out of here.
Tell him.
I'm going to have a baby.
Congratulations,
Grandpa. Here's what I'm thinking. I want to look younger.
Now it's out with the old.
Young, right?
It's bitchin'.
Bitchin'?
In with the new.
Hey, what do you think? I look like the guy you married, right?
Kind of. George, what's gotten into you, honey?
And,
kids, you're going to have a baby.
He's right back where he started.
Excuse me?
The bread and the woman! Get out of town! I was just guessing being a grandfather.
I think I'm gonna faint.
Honey, I need to know how you feel about all this.
They don't have hot dogs. Don't.
George.
No. I feel super about it. At least going to the movies, that'll be economical. One child, two seniors, thanks.
This Christmas,
we have Sturks, of course.
Sturks?
The best things in life.
Hello! That's good!
Are the least expected.
Dad, what are you taking?
Well, Dad hadn't been sleeping so well lately, so I thought I'd take a couple of very mild sleeping pills.
I couldn't sleep at all.
You gave him sleeping pills?
Mom!
What?
This is it.
I got it.
Touchstone Pictures presents Steve Martin.
Hey, man, what's with that face, huh?
Lock the door!
Diane Keaton.
Uh-oh. Nice timing, I know.
Dad!
I'm ready. Let's do it.
Martin Short.
George?
We're bonding here, aren't we?
We're moving her into delivery.
These women are my life.
And Kimberly Williams.
Dad.
Father of the Bride, Part 2.
I have the chair for the prostate exam.
Rachel, where are your father going?
I don't know, he was just here.
Come on in.
Do I know you?
A Nancy Myers, Charles Shire film.
Yeah, that trailer gave away a whole lot of the movie, man, especially the third act. I mean, wow. I do not remember them giving away that much in the trailer whenever I saw that for the first time, but there you go, right there. I mean, a lot of the end of this movie is in the last half of that trailer, and I'm just kind of like, that probably is not a good sign if you're giving away much of the movie in that little area there. But Father of the Bride Part 2, of course, like I said, this is a sequel to Father of the Bride, which in and of itself was a remake of the original film. The sequel is a remake of the sequel to that, which it's called Father's Little Dividend, which nowadays probably wouldn't have been an easy sell, so I could see why they went with Father of the Bride Part 2. And, there was a lot of intrigue with this sequel in particular, because when Disney made sequels to comedies like this, we had Three Men and a Little Lady, Sister Act 2, Another Stakeout, they did not usually do as well as the original films did. They were usually less than successful films. They weren't seen as good as compared to the first movie, so Father of the Bride Part 2 comes around, and I can easily say this, it's the best of the sequels that Touchstone has done with their comedies. It's not a great movie all around, but it definitely is something that I surprisingly found more enjoyable than the first movie. The first movie is a great film. I like the ideas that they have in this movie, having not only the daughter be pregnant, but also having Steve Martin's wife, Diane Keaton, be pregnant as well. It does lead to a lot of good comedic timing and a lot of good comedic ideas. And we've had comedies that focused on pregnancy that were not very good. Junior was was an example of that, and 9 Months, which came out in the same year. But this movie definitely, it felt like it did a lot more with the concept and the ideas that they had than those movies did. And of course you have Charles Shire and Nancy Myers, two very funny and very well, they do very well known writers and directors who have done some pretty good comedies before this and after this. Like, these are the guys that also did, they also did Baby Boom. They did Irreconcilable Differences. And then after this, they worked together on stuff like Alfie and the remake of Alfie, which is, I think, a very underrated remake. But Nancy Myers has done a lot of works, including The Parent Trap, What Women Want, Something's Gotta Give, The Holiday, It's Complicated, The Intern. She's made a lot of great movies, and, you know, it's not surprising that this movie is very enjoyable. Like, I think I'm one of the few people that would say that I actually did kind of find this a little bit more enjoyable than the first movie. I really liked the first movie a whole lot, and I thought this really exceeded a lot of my expectations, because they found a lot of ways to make the comedy work this time around. And yeah, there are those elements where it tries to go a little bit too close to being a little too, you know, dad joke type of things with like some of the younger humor that they have in here, but it's toned down and it's not all over the place, and it's only in little areas where it's just kind of like, yeah, it wasn't that great, but it was only for a few seconds. It's not like they're doing this the entire movie. And most of the time, it is kind of funny. Like, I love that idea that George, the Steve Martin character, decides to get his hair dyed. And it actually leads to a couple of decently funny moments in that particular case. But, yeah, I was pleasantly surprised at how much I really enjoyed this movie. I was not expecting to go into it liking it more than the first film. I thought, at the very least, I'd like it just as much as the original film, but it does find enough there to really put it over the original, the first movie that they did. And that was a real surprise for me. I was not expecting that with this movie. I remember the first time I saw it as a little kid, I thought it was all right. But as time went on and I finally got a chance to rewatch it again, I was just kind of like, you know what? I definitely like what you did there. You actually made something a little bit more fun than the original film. And you had a good concept to work off of. And you did a pretty good job of working on that front. And, you know, honestly, I would say that this is a really good sequel. It's definitely a little bit better than the first movie. Maybe not one of the greatest comedy sequels of all time, but definitely one of the biggest surprises I've seen in a long time. I really like this movie a lot more than the first film, which is very surprising, considering that I did very much enjoy the first film. So, anyway, that is Father of the Bride Part 2. So let's move on to that second movie that I haven't seen, but we can just talk about it real quickly, and that is, of course, Georgia.
Magic of the extraordinary movie critics are calling one of the 10 best films of the year. Jennifer Jason Leigh, an Academy Award nominee, Mayor Winningham, Georgia.
Yeah, I didn't know too much about this movie until I did the research for it, but it sounds pretty interesting. You have Jennifer Jason Leigh and Mayor Winningham, as the little clip there I showed you indicates, but Jennifer Jason Leigh plays this punky barroom singer who has this complicated relationship with her older sister, the older sister played by Georgia, and she's passionate, but is the younger sister, Sadie, is very passionate but self-destructive and lacking in technical skills. She tries to match Georgia's accomplishments by becoming the lead singer for the punk rock band, but is unsuccessful and destroys herself through drug abuse. And Sadie comes to Georgia seeking help after she ends a relationship, and a reluctant Georgia tries to help her sister out on a continued downward spiral. So basically, this sounds like a story that you're basically following two sisters around in their relationships, and that's really all I know about this movie. This director, I think I'm going to pronounce this name wrong, but I'll see here, Ulu Grosbard, Ulugrosbard. He's a Belgian director. He's actually made some notable films, including Who is Harry Kellerman and Why is He Saying These Terrible Things About Me, which I think got some Oscar nominations in the 70s. The last movie he did before this was Falling in Love with Robert De Niro and Meryl Streep back in 1984, and they were pretty big stars back then. That movie was a notorious bomb. This person would make one more movie after this, and that is The Deep End of the Ocean with Michelle Pfeiffer, but we'll get to that one when we get to 99, but that's pretty much all I know about this one. It's got a decent cast to it, besides William Winningham. You got Ted Levine, John C. Reilly, Smokey Hormel, Jimmy Z, Joe Miller, these notable names in music. I mean, it could be interesting. I see some good reviews for it, so it definitely has the potential to be something pretty good, but I really don't know too much about this movie to really deviate into it, so yeah, that's pretty much all I got for you on this one. So that's Georgia. So on that note, we wrap up this edition of Time About the Movies. Next time, we've got some more notable holiday releases, including Robin Williams starring in Jumanji. We also have Robert De Niro and Al Pacino starring in Michael Mann's Heat. Harrison Ford, Greg Kinnear, and Julia Ormond starring in Sabrina. Emma Thompson starring in Sense and Sensibility, and we also have Kenneth Branagh's Othello. So five movies to look at next time around. Technically six, but it says here The City of Lost Children. I covered that already in a June review when it came out in June, so they put it up here twice. But so technically there's six movies here, but since I covered The City of Lost Children already, we're just going to look at the five movies I mentioned. Jumanji, Heat, Sabrina, Sense and Sensibility, and Othello. So we'll look at those five movies next time. But until then, thank you very much for watching. And if you want to see more videos like this, please hit the plays on the next page. Check out the previous episode. And I'll see you guys tomorrow for another episode. So thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. And until then, as always, take care.